Welcome to this walkthrough of getting a unique entity ID in SAM.gov. This video will show you how to get your unique entity identifier without completing an entity registration. The unique entity ID is a 12-character alphanumeric value assigned, managed, and owned by the federal government. SAM.gov is the system that assigns it. When you request a unique entity ID, your organization's legal business name and address will be validated. Validation is a verification that your organization is what you say it is. SAM.gov uses an entity validation service, or EVS, to independently verify the existence and uniqueness of an entity. What's the difference between only getting a unique entity ID and registering your entity? An entity registration allows your organization the opportunity to receive a contract or assistance directly from the federal government, not from another contractor or awardee. You must register your entity in SAM.gov when you want to bid on federal contracts as a prime contractor or seek a federal assistance as a prime awardee. Entity registrations include getting the unique entity ID and require assertions, representations and certifications, and other information about your business. Some organizations that do business with the federal government, such as subawardees, do not directly bid on contracts or apply for assistance and may not need to complete an entity registration. There may be other situations where a federal agency directs you to get a unique entity ID or to register in SAM.gov. Let's walk you through the steps to request a unique entity ID. Before we begin, make sure that you can officially document your entity's legal business name, physical address, start year or year of incorporation, state of incorporation, and your national identifier if your entity is based outside of the United States. You also need to set up a SAM.gov user account. Select Sign In from the upper right corner of the SAM.gov homepage and accept the government terms. Login.gov manages usernames and passwords for SAM.gov. If you already have a login.gov account, you can connect your SAM.gov account to it by signing in here. If you do not have a login.gov account, select Create an account and follow the directions. When you sign in from the SAM.gov homepage, you will be navigated to your workspace. On the Entities widget, select the Get Started button to begin your request for a unique entity ID. You will see a welcome screen. You will answer two questions about your goal and who asked you to come to SAM.gov. SAM.gov will then recommend a registration option based on the answers you've provided. Enter your legal business name and your organization's physical address. SAM.gov will search the EVS database for your information. Confirm that you can provide entity documentation if it is required. Before you get started, you can review a list of the acceptable documentation from this list. If the database locates your entity or similar entities that could be yours, you will see the Review Entity Information page. If you see an entity in the list that you recognize as yours, select the I Recognize My Entity option. Select the entity in the list, and then select Next. On this page, confirm if all the information on this entity that you have selected is correct. If it is correct, select Yes, and then Next. If some details are incorrect, such as your entity name is missing, the LLC, or it has your old address, or it's missing your suite number, we will walk you through how to update it later in this video. Next, enter your entity start year and state of incorporation. Entities based outside of the United States may be asked for a national identifier here. Now that you have confirmed your information, you can select Receive Unique Entity ID to be assigned your unique entity ID. You will have the option here to restrict the public search of your information. If you uncheck this box, only you and federal government users will be able to search and view your entity information. You must also check the box certifying that you are authorized to conduct transactions for this entity. Select Receive Unique Entity ID. Congratulations! You have gotten your unique entity ID. SAM.gov will send you an email confirmation with the unique entity ID in it. If all you needed was the unique entity ID, then you're done. If you need to view your unique entity ID in the future, or if you need to update your entity's information, just go to the Entities widget in your workspace. After entering your entity's information and searching the SAM.gov database, if you do not see the Review Entity Information page, your information is unavailable in the database. But don't worry, you can add it. Just go to the documentation portion of this video for your next steps. If you see an entity in the list that you recognize as yours, but some details are incorrect, you can update them. Select I recognize my entity, select the entity, and then select Next. On this page, confirm whether or not all of the information on the entity you select is correct. If some details are incorrect, such as your entity name is missing the LLC, or it has your old address, or is missing a suite number, then select No, and then select Next. Here you can update incorrect information. Select the checkboxes next to what needs updating. For example, if the entity name is correct but the physical address needs a change, you should only select the physical address box. Then enter the current correct information, then select Next. Enter your entity's start year and state of incorporation. Entities based outside of the United States may be asked for a national identifier here. Confirm your information on the next page. If you are correcting parts of your entity information, the parts you are updating are listed. The next page is the Document Your Entity Details page. If your entity information is not yet in the EVS database, or if you need to correct or update the entity information, you will need to provide documents that prove your current correct entity information. Review the requirements carefully. The entity information you must document is listed on this page. Go to the Acceptable Documents link for more information on what types of documentation will be accepted to validate your entity. Once you submit your documents, you will receive a Federal Service Desk or FSD reference number, and the Entity Validation Service will then review your documents. Monitor your email for messages about the status of your validation. An agent will reach out to you by email if more information is required. Once your entity is validated, you should start the Get Unique Entity ID process again. After you enter your information and search the database, your entity will be available in the legal entities list. Follow the steps earlier in the video to receive your unique entity ID. Thank you for watching this video on how to get your unique entity ID.